you're someone that struggles with outdoor scenes in 3D and how to make them look more photorealistic, how to make them look more professional, and just overall well put together, today I'm going to go over a few tips that I use and have been applying to my students to help their outdoor scenes just look drastically better. So this project is Kenza's project. You'll see the before. This was a work in progress, and she's a student in our program, so we're basically going over what we can apply to the project to make it look much, much better without having to change big things like the modeling or the texturing of the actual project. And then you'll see after a lot of the changes are made, the project just looks drastically better. She's actually developing this project and making it into something really nice. Everything was custom done by her, the labels, the bottle. Her links will be in the descriptions. If you've got a company that needs visualizations for products like this, then I'll definitely reach out to her. She's great to work with. So step one is the camera. That's the first place that I would start. So by default, you get a 36 milliliter camera, which looks okay in general. But I always recommend for outdoor scenes especially, use a compressed lens. So we bumped our lens up to 35 millimeters. We straightened out our camera here so that it's not at an angle looking down and up. Then we can zoom out just to get the product to fill the frame again and move the camera up a little bit like this. The compressed lens does two things. It stops distortion of the product if the camera is very close up, so the product doesn't look like it's getting stretched and stuff, but it also separates the background from the product and removes a lot of the visual distractions, which just drastically makes your scene look better. Already we're seeing quite a big improvement on the scene already, and we really haven't changed anything but the camera. And then the next thing I would look at is the camera settings. So you can increase the depth of field here. Let's say we go 0.9. That will increase the background blur, which separates the product from the background even more. What I also like to do is increase the aperture edge to like 2. That'll increase the highlights around the depth of field, which I find that it often just makes your products look more pretty and your scenes more pretty. It looks more visually interesting because the background and the bokeh has highlights, which often increases the aesthetic visual appeal. So already we're seeing a big improvement to the scene. The next thing I would look at is the lighting. So if we look at an outdoor lighting perspective, what we need is more direct sunlight to cast shadows. I can insert a sunlight here. I can, you know, make it minus 30 degrees so that it's facing downwards a little bit like this and it's not straight on, so that it looks more like a sun. Maybe we do like minus 60 and now it's like more of a daylight. Then we can angle it to the side so that there's some light coming from the side here. So let's say we go 60 degrees this way. Let's try 60 degrees the other way. And now you can see we've got some sunlight, but it's coming in from the side, which add some actual shadows, which is what you'd see in real life, to the scene itself. So now it's casting shadows on the fruit and on the wood, and immediately our scene just looks way better. Now that's on the sunlight and the environment. What I'd also do with the sunlight is tick on mix sky texture so that the sunlight and the HDRI are collaborative. The next thing I would look at is the area lights, if you have any. So the area lights here, I would add some gradients on them. It'll just make your product look more visually appealing. So on the left side, we can add a gradient onto that one and we can look at which way it's facing. Generally, you want the softer and the darker part to face inwards. So here we need to invert it so that the one on the left, you know, is pointing inwards. And then we add a gradient onto the right side as well, like this. And now our lighting will just look a bit better, both on the product, but also just the sunlighting, the HDRI. You can rotate the HDRI different angles to see, you know, what's the most appealing look for you. And immediately, just a few minutes after making these changes, you can see the beginning and the way it looked there. And the way it looks now is just drastically different. And we haven't really changed much about the scene, but you know, the camera and a bit of lighting, like we haven't really needed to change anything that drastic. The next thing I would look at is, you know, post-processing, because in reality, a sun would often cast some glows and rays and stuff onto your scene. So you can add some post-processing. If we increase this to like 250 here, we see what that looks like. We need to cut it off a little bit so that it's not glowing on everything and maybe just on the sun here. So we just need to optimize this depending on the scene that you have to get the post-processing in just the right place. Maybe we'll decrease the intensity a little bit so it's not as strong. And now you'll see that we've got some of these like glow and stuff, which is what you'd see in reality if the sun was very strong, which just adds a bit more realism. The sun, you can also increase the sun size to like 10 or 20, because in real life, you know, the sun is very big, and with a bigger sun and a bigger light source, you get softer shadows. So that also might help your scenes look a bit better. Of course, you run through all the basic things in 3D, geometry checks, topology checks, materials. In Kenza's case, one little thing that we spotted that she was missing is on her droplets, she needed to tick on fake shadows because right now the droplets are having this black look on the front, which is not correct. So the fake shadows will help with that so that it's more transparent and just increases the realism a little bit more as well. Overall, her materials and textures and stuff are set up very well. There's just like a few little things like that that was affecting it. So here I can rotate the HDRI. You can try it like 30 degree increments to see what's the best angle. I might say like, wow, I really like this angle here. It's bright, it's beautiful. You need to spend a bit of time actually testing this for your scene. And then you need to clean up and organize your scene because often clutter and disorganization with your project structure filters into your scene. So I'll group everything correctly, label everything correctly, remove things that you don't need. So all your lights you can put under a lighting null. Everything that you don't need or won't use, you can remove. Your products you can put under a group and null. All of these things just to remove any distractions because you don't want things that are not needed to be taking away from your scene. And already I've gone and deleted a bunch of stuff. And now we're just seeing like what the scene should look like without all of those distractions. Here we're already seeing it's already looking visually better. We might be lacking some lighting on the front, so that's something that we can fix. We can go into the sunlight again here, and maybe we can rotate this a little bit so that it's a bit more front on, so that we have more lighting on the front of the product and it's not so dark. You can adjust your area lights. There's a lot of things that you can do depending on the scene that you have. If we go into the render settings here, also increasing your specular depth, adding in global illumination, all of these things will all help your scene look better. Denoising, making sure your imager is set up, all of that stuff. And now instantly we're seeing a huge difference from the way it started. Now what we can do, we can start to introduce things to the scene that just makes it look more visually complex. An example of that would be more products, more fruits. You can add leaves in the background. All of this stuff will help. So here, if I just go into the scene itself and I just start to, you know, increase the more visual complexity. So here I can take the fruits, I can instance this to help save on memory and stuff like that. So here we have a copy of the initial object. We can then go and move that object to another part of the scene. Let's say here, you can go rotate it as well, like so. Then you can take your main product. You can also create an instance of that as well. So here I can say instance. Everything that's attached to your main product as well, you can put inside there. So you don't need this bottle, so we can delete that. The condensation that she created, you can put that inside of your main product. So that's also instanced as well. Then you take your main product, you know, you just move it to the back. Maybe you move this fruit that way, like that. This one, we can rotate, you know, 20 degrees that way. And then it's just gonna point outwards a little bit. Then we can create a copy of the instance as well. We can rotate this one 20 degrees and then we can just move it to, you know, another part of the scene, let's say back there. Now we've got three copies of the same product, and if we go back into our camera view here, you'll see that the scene starts to get put together simply because we've got more visual elements in the scene and it's not looking so bland and simple. So already we're seeing a huge difference just from a few minutes of making tweaks to this project. And if we had to recap, like your camera, the compression, the depth of field, lighting, visual complexity in the scene, post-processing, all of these things help build up your scene. Of course, you can see that she modeled it very well. She set up the materials, the textures, all the basic stuff very well. Kenza actually custom built everything herself. The labels she custom created herself. So it's really cool because now she has full control over the animation of everything. And I think she wants to animate the textures and flowers and stuff and turn this into a really cool advertisement. Now that the quality of her work is increasing and we're helping her build a network, she's actually getting clients reach out to her for projects like this, which is really cool. Hopefully all of this stuff helped. Try to apply them to your scenes and see if your outdoor scenes look better. If you'd like to get your projects broken down by me personally, like Kenza did and I helped her, check out our free training, schedule a call with us, and hopefully we'll be able to help, and maybe you could be part of our mastermind too. Chat soon and have a great day.